Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we have just one small SpaceX article to look at, so most of the video will be spent over in Boca Chica as well as looking at Starship. So let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting this video is a new article from CNBC with regards to a SpaceX presentation to the FCC last month. During the presentation, apparently SpaceX said that they were producing 120 Starlink satellites per month. Not only that, but apparently SpaceX have invested over $70 million developing and producing thousands of consumer user terminals per month. As I said, just one bit of SpaceX information, so now let's go to Boca Chica and see what's up. Something we've not seen too much recently, here we have workers pouring concrete over by the Super Heavy launch pad. I just want to show you a cool aerial shot once again from Mauricio at RGV Aerial Photography. Just a reminder that the Cessna and pilot services to get the awesome aerial photos is expensive. If you can, go and support their Patreon, link in the description. Anyway, here you can see that we have a great shot of the launch pad foundations and it's looking good. We've recently seen the arrival of a new Manitowoc crane that was also seen being put together last episode. They've also been spotted with a Manitowoc 14,000 crane over by the launch pad construction. Whether it's the same crane, I'm not sure, but either way, this thing is a behemoth. Also spotted has been a bunch of rebar bits and pieces, I believe. So hopefully, in the not too distant future, we might start seeing them build the actual structure for the pad. Not too far away from there is the launch mount in which SN5 recently lifted off from. You can see that SpaceX is continuing post-hop work and repairs on the mount in preparation for future testing, more on that later in the video. Nearby, the company has been beginning some work with the ground, and whilst I may be wrong, I believe here they are driving piles. I wonder what it is they are planning to construct here. Just behind the test mount for Starship prototypes, there was recently another test tank which was SN7. Whilst it has been removed since its test of failure, it appears that workers are now doing further work over by the test area. Next to the Starship launch mount, there were some new buildings being constructed and a wall going up. Looks like now there's even more foundational work going on for yet another building. At the moment, it's not clear what exactly the newly built structures will be used for, nor what this new one will be. However, here we have a closer view of part of what has already been constructed. If you know what this could be, let me know down in the comments. As you will all have probably seen in recent videos, SpaceX have been working on a new restaurant or eating area. They added the old Mark 1 fins to make the place look cooler, and now they've added some greenery to make it a more relaxing environment. The area is turning into such a cool place. At the production area of the facility, the high bay construction has obviously progressed some more. All four corners are now put together, and so next up for Bluezilla will be to level up the high bay with level 4. To finish up the Boca Chica updates, before we look at Starships and future testing to expect, we have the scrap pile. What you can see is some old Starship legs that are no longer needed. However, there are some new legs that have been spotted at the SpaceX facility, likely the version 1.1 legs that Musk mentioned. Moving on to Starship pieces, over by the nose cone area, a nose was moved inside the tent once again. A new section inside of a tent with TPS tiles has also been spotted. You can see the X shape the workers have created with these heat shield tiles. I wonder what Starship serial number this will be for. Right now, I'm going to guess SN8. There's also a fantastic close-up of these thermal protection tiles. I'm not sure what this attachment method is, although I do know they've previously attempted stud welding. Will be interesting to see how these hold up when the Starship that this section belongs to flies. In terms of heat shield tiles, Musk was asked, are these different heat shields on each vehicle? Are you still experimenting with materials or welding techniques for the tiles? He responded by saying, same hex tile, slightly different mounting method, need bigger sections of tiles to see how they hold up with cryo shrinkage, pressure expansion and body bending. So, another interesting thing we've seen recently is work being done on the retired SN2 bopper. This test tank is still undergoing work with what appears to be some sort of piping. Again, it's always uncertain what they are doing when they do unexpected stuff like this. With a closer look, inside the concrete stand the tank is sitting on, you can see even more piping. The only thing I can think they might be doing is building a storage unit for some sort of liquid. Moving on to SN5, which has recently still been chilling out on the landing pad after its awesome little flight. SpaceX have been working on preparing the vehicle to move it back to the construction yard as well as doing some inspections. Then, early in the week, the tank was placed onto the roll lift. On Tuesday, the road to the Boca Chica beach was closed and the SN5 prototype started rolling down the road. Some hour or so later, it had pretty much arrived in the production area to go through some probably very thorough inspections. They should hopefully get some very good practice for the many tests to come. Just before we move on to information about testing, you can see here we have SN6. It's still hanging out in the mid-bay along with the partially stacked SN8 prototype. However, SN6's time in the mid-bay is now over and her spot will be replaced with SN5. As always, Everyday Astronaut asked Elon Musk on Twitter about what we can expect with SN5. He asked, will it fly again? Will it get free Raptors and fly a little higher? Will it hopper and just watch the others fly? Musk responded with some exciting information by saying, not sure yet, but hopefully, we'll need leg and other repairs, probably SN6 flies before SN5, we need to make flights simple and easy, many per day. So here's the crazy part, whilst SN5 was rolled back into the construction yard, SN6 was rolled out. It was placed onto the roll lift just outside the mid bay in order to head over to the pad and hop on the test stand. It was then obviously rolled down the road and into the testing area of the facility, thanks S Padre for filming this. SN6 has not yet been placed on the test stand since I believe it's still undergoing some preparations. However, hopefully we don't have nearly as many delays with this prototype as with SN5. Yesterday, Musk also tweeted a picture of the two Starship prototypes side by side in the construction area. He tweeted SN5 and SN6 at Starship Production Complex in Texas. In response to his own tweet with the picture of the two tanks, Musk added some information about SN7. He said, SN7 will be new alloy test tank taken to burst pressure, SN8 will have body flaps and nose cone. Incredibly exciting and I cannot wait until SpaceX are testing and flying more regularly. With two Starship tanks in the inventory plus a whole load of Starships in the works, we could start seeing it more often. As always though, an enormous thank you to the one and only Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, for her time and dedication. Also, thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team for all their coverage and live streams, as well as Jack Beyer with his great editing. We all thank each of you immensely. Also, thank you to Mauricio of RGV Aerial Photography for his time and own money he spends getting incredible aerial photos. Remember, the flights are expensive, so the Patreon link is down in the description. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.